Hello guys, welcome back to the video from the Innovators. I know guys, we haven't been uploading videos for quite a while, but from now on we'll try to upload as regularly as possible. So let's get started with today's video. In today's video, we are building a TV remote with the help of an Arduino and Android app. In this project, we'll be using MIT App Inventor, Arduino IDE, an Arduino UNO, Bluetooth module HC05, IRM meter, TSOP1738 receiver, a 1 kilo ohm resistor and some jumper wires. We have completed some of the projects related to the MIT App Inventor in the past on our channel. If you guys want to watch them, please click on the link in the description below. First of all, let's see how the basic remote control works. Each button on the remote when pressed emits its own hexadecimal code with the help of IRM meter. First, we will have to decode the code with the help of TSOP1738. Let's see how to do that. In this circuit, we will need TSOP1738, Arduino UNO, breadboard, universal remote and some jumper wires. For TSOP1738, as we see it from the upper round side, first one is the ground, middle one is VCC and the last one is the output pin. Place TSOP1738 on the breadboard. Connect the ground pin with the ground pin of the Arduino. Connect VCC pin with the VCC pin of the Arduino. And connect the output pin on the pin number 11 of the Arduino. Moving on with the coding, we need to download IR library that you can download with the link given in the description below. Click over here on the zip file. I have already downloaded it. Move to Arduino IDE and select the sketch option from the above. Then press include and add zip library. A small window will appear. From the folder option on the left side of that window, select the directory where you download the zip file. Error that occurs here is because we already include library in our Arduino IDE. Code is already provided in the GitHub link given in the description below. Now just verify the code and upload it into the Arduino. By the help of our circuit, we can find out the proper code of the particular button of the TV remote control that is available. After some time, you will see some random codes will appear on the screen. By pressing a particular button several times, we can find out the constant code or the value of that particular button. As you can see, there are many random codes. A single button, but the most common one is 10E5EB14. Just copy that code and place it on the power section. After copying each and every code of the button of the TV remote control, we need to add 0 and small x before every code. Let's discuss the programming part. First of all, include the two libraries. First is irremote, second one is software serial.h. Now declare the variable irsender, then make the array of the channel code with the data type hexadecimal. Add the code of the channel from 0 to 9 into it from the notepad. Furthermore, declare the Bluetooth module, RX and TX pin, respectively at pin number 10 and pin number 11. And finally, declare string variable name state. In the setup part, we have to initialize serial and Bluetooth module. To know further more, visit the playlist of the MIT App Inventor. Let's discuss the programming logic. First, if there is the value in the state, so it will enter into the loop. Then it will check whether it is the number or not. If it is the number, so enter it in the if loop, otherwise in the else loop. Now program check whether it is volume up, volume down, power or mute as the value of the state. It will enter in the loop. In the case variable is string, so we convert it into the integer by using another variable named as instate, and instate is divided into two variables named as 10 and 1. For example, the user enters switch, the channel 62, so 6 will store in the variable 10, and then 2 will be stored in the variable 1. or if user wants to switch into one digit channel, then from example 2, so 0 will store in the variable 10 and 2 will store in the variable 1. If we do not have any number, then it will move to the else part, in which check whether the command is volume up, volume down, power or mute. Go to the site of the MIT App Inventor and open the dashboard of the MIT App Inventor. Here we already have designed a basic interface of the MIT App Inventor. First, from the component section, we include Bluetooth from connectivity and clock from the sensor. These are non-visible components, so they can be shown under our app interface. Secondly, in the block coding, we introduce some of the blocks from the back. If you want to know how they are working, you can check our MIT App Inventor playlist. First two ones are from Bluetooth connectivity, and third, which is clock, are from the real-time operation. After that, we include when do button, and after that we introduce if then block. In if block, we place Bluetooth client is connected, and in then block place Bluetooth client dot send text, and in text block place text box 1 and text. For power button, we duplicate the above part, just change button 1 to button 2, and in text block we place empty text box and just write power in it. For volume up, we duplicate the above part, just change button 2 to button 3, and in empty text box write volume up in it. Duplicate it again for volume down and change button 3 to button 4, and in empty text box write volume down in it. For button 5, which is for the mute, we duplicate the above part, just change button 4 to button 5, and in empty text box write mute. And finally, our program or the code is done. Finally, let's build the main circuit for our app. In this circuit, we will need breadboard, Arduino UNO, Bluetooth module HC05, IR LED, 1K resistor and some jumper wires. First of all, place Bluetooth module in the breadboard. Connect VCC pin and ground pin of the Bluetooth module to 5 volts and the ground pin of the Arduino UNO respectively. Connect the long leg of the IR emitter in pin number 3, and short leg of the IR emitter is connected to one leg of the 1 kilo ohm resistor, and the other leg of the resistor is connected to the ground. Let's see the working process.